Hey there. So this is actually an answer to a request that we got on a comment. So someone named I Rose, hello, asked if I would do a full rundown of my daughter's, let's call it fourth grade curriculum. I say let's call it because if you homeschool and if you've been homeschooling for a while, you know that grades are totally irrelevant once you start homeschooling pretty quickly. So she asked that we do a full rundown of the curriculum we'll be using. I usually do little subject by subject videos because we use a lot of different stuff and because I talk a lot. So I'm going to try to make this pretty brief and see if I can make it not, you know, the world's longest curriculum haul. And it's not a haul because I actually own most of this stuff already. So let's jump into it. So we're going to be doing several different things for language arts this year. My daughter is starting the Classical Conversations Essentials program. So their core of that program is the Essentials English Language Curriculum, which is the one to the furthest left. The next part that they include in that is IEW's U.S. history-based writing lessons. Now, it's only this themed writing lesson because we're entering into cycle three, which is based on the modern time period and specifically focused on American history. So excited to do that and coming up with a lot of fun stuff to add in with that. And then we are finishing up all about reading level three. So we did level two at the beginning of the year. They're pretty quick. They're like 60 lessons. So we can get through a full lesson in one sitting if we want to push through. But sometimes we do make that two sittings. So we usually do one or two a week. On those, on a good week, we'll do at least two. So I would like us to do more than that, but we've been a little scatterbrained. We've got a new baby, so we're doing what we can. But we did level two at the beginning of the year and we're doing level three. We should have that completed by the fall. So the like start of the new year, our year starts and stops like when June becomes July. So we're at the very tail end of our year and it's about to start. And we are full year round. So that like June 30th, July 1st cutoff is pretty meaningful for us because that's, you know, when we want everything to have been wrapped up that we wanted wrapped up. But ultimately, if we carry it over into the next year, it doesn't matter. So we hopefully will have that wrapped up by about August, September, and then we'll go into all about reading level four. Now, I actually had a conversation with my daughter about this last night because we were doing a swing into reading, all about reading level three lesson. And she was saying, what are we going to do when I'm done with this? And I said, well, there's a level four. And she said, great. Is there a level five? No, there is not. Okay, can we do level four twice? I'm like, well, yeah, if you are still struggling with reading, then we'll probably just do level four again. Who knows? We might go back and do level two again, and then level three again, and then level four again, just so that there's more variety to it. You know, whatever, it doesn't matter. You're still, you know, reinforcing that reading, but we kind of set a goal for her on why we're doing this. You know, I work outside the home. So in business, there's the really annoying question of what's your why? Why do you do this? So I was like, okay, well, let's give you a why goal. So we kind of talked about it and her why is she wants to be able to sit in her room and read a Terry Pratchett book, which is a pretty decently high reading level. On her own without any help and actually understand it. So that's great. You know, we read those. I think we self-edit as we read a little bit, but there's really not that much that would be inappropriate for kids. I've read those books like a million times and they're pretty darn kid friendly. Then I just said darn. So, well, they're pretty kid friendly. So, you know, there's no like cursing. There's no inappropriate themes. There is like magic and witchcraft and stuff, but it's happening on an alternate world. So that's okay. So we're going to be doing the All About Reading track as long as it goes. And then for grammar, in addition to essentials, we also do English Grammar Recitation by Memoria Press. And I just like the way things are phrased. I like that it's this tiny little book. It comes with a teacher's guide and a student guide, and you can fill things out, and that's lovely. We probably won't be doing that. We'll probably just be doing the memory work for it because we're doing so much else. So much else. All this other stuff. Sorry, it's like 7 in the morning for me. Forgive me if my words are a little bit fumbly. We're doing other things in addition to this. So if you've seen any of my shorts, which I'm not great at shorts, so I hope they're okay. If you've seen any of my shorts that I've been doing, there's lots of trivium tables, which is memory work for the Essentials program that we'll be using. There's a diagramming sentences book that we've already started using. I gave a bit of a talk on this when I think it was when I was doing my like classical conversations versus Memoria Press video, which I really liked the cover on that one. I thought it was fun. But we're kind of previewing the program over the summer, and then that way we won't feel like we're blindly stumbling into it when the year starts. That's not something that CC expects you to do by any means. We just feel that we'd be more comfortable if we did it that way. So we're doing it that way. So I think we're on like our 6th week of essentials for the summer. We've done maybe like 4 of the writing lessons. So we're not doing it exactly perfect like they would do it, but we're trying to preview it. And we haven't been having her do the writing lessons. We're doing it all verbally at this point. And having her, you know, so in the US history-based writing lessons, they'll make keyword outlines. So they'll read a, you know, 1 or 2 paragraph long story, and then they'll write out a little outline so that they can then retell the information. It's note-taking, basically, at the very beginning of the book. It gets far more advanced later. But at the beginning of the book, that's what they're working on. So we've been having her learn the rules of the note-taking keyword outline thing, and then just give it to us verbally, because we've been doing these on a lot of car rides. I guess it's because, you know, like everyone's contained and you can just sit there and do it and the boys aren't going crazy. So anyways, that's kind of what we're doing for English language arts. Then there's math. Now, math is one of my daughter's absolute favorite subjects. It's where she excels to kind of a ridiculous level. She's 9 years old and we are currently on Beast Academy 5B. So we're halfway through the Beast Academy level 5. Level 5 is not 5th grade. You can watch some of my math videos on Beast Academy where I kind of go through it. But I think Beast Academy is for like 11 to 13 year olds on their website. So it's middle school. So she's doing Beast Academy level 5, and after this we'll either put her into pre-algebra or introduction to algebra, which is algebra 1. I still need to research art of problem solving's middle and high school levels a little bit more because it's pretty complex. They've been around for a long time. It seems like a lot of homeschool curriculums have been around for like 5 minutes. And Beast Academy is relatively newer, but Art of Problem Solving has been around for a very long time. And these books are very traditional and they appear pretty dense. And I don't know if it's the right fit. I don't. I would love her to do these because they're on the same track. It's the same company. So it should be fun and challenging in the same way. But I'm a little intimidated by the way it's laid out. I'm a little intimidated by the, honestly, small print, lack of color, lack of fun. I'm going to miss the fun monsters. And I know she's going to miss the fun monsters. And the games. There were so many games with Beast Academy. So even if we do pre-algebra and algebra one next year, and we don't know, I'm probably going to do their online tests when we're done with level five and kind of see where she's going to fit. They say that once you're done with level five, you can kind of go into either one. So we're going to check on that and see exactly where she's ready. I've also been supplementing with a lot of just homemade curriculum, where I've been trying to go, okay, Beast Academy does things in these wonderful, creative, out-of-the-box ways. But if we bring it down to bare bones basics, like, can you do this like really easily on your own? You can't. Good. Okay. Just making sure. Move on. So that's where we're at on math. I'm not going to talk endlessly on math because I do have videos where we talk for a very long time on math. And you know what? Honestly, if she slows down and does level five and that takes her until January or February, I'm perfectly fine. That's good because she, you know, is kind of at a weird break point on the levels for Beast Academy. Anyways, it's not lining up with our start and beginning of year. She started level five in February. So, you know, if it takes her a full year, that's fine. I'd be happy with that. It means we found her level, right? So rather than, you know, the years when she did like two or three levels at once or two or three levels in a year, like kindergarten when she did in first grade, second grade. Anyways, so that's math for this year, and we'll just keep you updated and see how it goes. And I have no idea where she's going to be at by this time next year. I don't know if she will have done pre-algebra. I don't know if she will have just finished up level five, which perfectly fine, way to go kiddo, or if she did algebra one, or if she started one and then we decided we hated it and switched to a completely different program. I really don't know. It could go one of many ways for math. So next we have our history curriculum. And honestly, whenever we talk about history, I like to have my husband here, but he is kind of busy when I do these videos because he's watching our three kids. So our history curriculum, we're doing what we did for cycle three last year with more. Or not last year, last cycle. So last cycle, we did the Who Was series. And we did a lot of Who Was books. We did, I think, like 120 Who Was books in 1 year. So that was a lot. That was a lot. So we have all of those books. We're going to read them again. The nice thing is that some of them are actually at her reading level. So we're going to have her read at least parts of them as part of this, or at least that's the goal. Then in addition to that, we're doing Memoria Press's States and Capitals. We might have that finished by the time we're at the beginning of our CC year. So I've also done state studies. on most of the states. I'm almost done. And I have those in a TPT shop just because, hey, if I'm making it, like other people might want it. So I've made those, and there are 5 pages per state, which is more than the Memoria Press states and capitals, which I love and I bought and it's great. But I wanted like a second step. So I wanted something a little bit deeper because the states and capitals one that they have is kind of geared at, I think, a third grade level. And I wanted something a little bit more in depth. So mine has a like fact sheet about the states where it has, you know, a history section and then all the major facts, including like what are the state parks and the information that like I wanted to know. So here are the major geographical features in the state history, all that kind of stuff. And then it has a map labeling page, a map drawing page, and then it has like a quiz every 5 states. So anyways, it has that, which is kind of cool. And then I also have been making, because the Who Was books, they're not really a curriculum, right? You can buy from the Waldock Way different Who Was book, like book studies on them and activity packets for the different Who Was books, which is really cool that she does that. I'm not doing that. Instead, I've kind of done, okay, if that's what her read alouds are gonna be, or the Who Was cycle again, and we have a lot of other read alouds for American history, so I didn't feel like we needed to buy a whole new curriculum for it. In addition to that, I've made a bunch of games and history packets. So just like bringing the fun into it and then also bringing, you know, some depth into it. So I have like exploring grammar through American historical documents and stuff like that. So we're going to use a lot of that stuff, and I'm going to keep making it throughout the year so that we have more of that to do. I've been making these little packets for different holidays and things, and we found that we've really, really enjoyed them. So we're going to do more of that. So that's kind of what we're working on for history. I haven't done our big history video yet, but I will probably do that and go like, and here's this book and this book and this book and this book. I have done several in my like shorts. So you can see like, if you know, there's not me really talking about them. It's just like, here's a book, here's a book, here's a book, here's a book. And we got a lot of those off of like libraryandeducationalresources.com. I think that's what the website's called. And we just got a whole bunch of packs when we did CC Cycle 3, which is American history, the first time. So we're going to use those again because that was the point. It was, hey, if I'm going to spend this kind of money, it's going to be stuff we can use for all of our kids every 3 years. So it's going to pay off. And hopefully it will, and we'll love it. And hopefully, you know, it's in depth enough, all the stuff we have for American history, that I can use it again 3 years from now. That's the goal. All right. So that's history. Okay. So I haven't done our science recap video or what we're doing for science next year yet. And those are probably coming. But like history, I like to do these with my husband because I'm usually not there when these are getting done. These are read aloud subjects for us. And I don't read for 3 hours a day. Sorry. My husband does. He will, you know, probably like 5 hours a day. I mean, the guy can talk. So we are probably going to be paring down science this year. I might be making some more like science memory work things that like expand on the CC science memory work, and some other little engaging things for science. But for the most part, we're going to be focusing on, and I always botch the name of this, brain builders, something like that. The Science in the series. And I absolutely love these. We have at least one of them on audio. And I asked Dr. Jay Willi at a homeschool conference if he had any plans of putting any more of them on audio, because we love listening to it in the car. So he doesn't. They're very expensive to produce. He says he will never make his money back in a million years on the first one. So he's not going to do it because there's just not enough of a market for it. And they are very expensive to make. Darn. So we have done science in the beginning and science in the ancient through Renaissance time period. So next we'll be doing science in the scientific revolution, and we might get into the next one, which is the age of reason, but I don't know how much science we're going to be doing this year. It's a really, really heavy language arts year for us because we're starting the essentials curriculum. So I don't know. Science is one of those things that, like, even though my daughter really would like to go into the sciences, we kind of put it on the back burner. She really loves it. It's a read aloud subject for her, and she loves being read to, and she loves answering comprehension questions and all of that. But where I'm willing to do like 15,000 things for language arts and math, I'm not willing to do 15,000 things for science yet. I think we probably do more than we should anyways, but we'll probably do even more when she gets older. For right now, there's only so much time of the day, and we're probably going to stick to one curriculum and just do this. And if she only gets through 1 year of it in 1 year, hey, that's what it was designed to be, and that's fine. So that's what we're doing for next year. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you for watching all the way to the end. Remember to like and subscribe. And I'll see you on the next one. Oh, and by the way, look what I look like when I do my hair. This is a constant reminder that I should put more effort into things. But I probably won't. See you next time, probably with a bun. Bye.